Thank you.
Hey, everybody, what's up?
Hey, how's it going, guys?
It's Damian. He's visiting us in the practice room, and he's got some grip knowledge for us. Now, you come from a drum corps background, correct?
Yes.
Pretty strong.
I marched, I didn't march corps, but I did march drum corps style. I marched that from junior high up through, 2 years of college. So
I've seen some of the videos you put up. Nice stuff, dude. So I'm waiting to get inside the grip that you got for sure. So what do you got?
A lot of the things I've struggled with mainly has been my grip, and a lot of the bad habits I've developed have somewhat come from marching band, because when you're in that situation, you're having to learn someone else's style. And everybody has their own doctrine, which in the end becomes its own gospel truth, because everything has to be uniform across the line. If you're learning a snare grip, odds are it's not going to be what's conventional for you to play on the kit, because you're not going to play on the drum kit like this, like you would be in a line of 10. So
I never thought of that. Seriously. Wow, that's interesting.
So, I mean, not to name any names, but, there's a particular drum corps out there that, likes to have the elbow kind of high, when they're marching, and that's just their style.
I think they know who they are.
But great band, but, it tends to give you a lot of bad habits in the long run.
I get that, yeah.
I originally started on snare, so I did, I guess, what you call the American grip.
Uh-huh.
Which is palms down, somewhere in between the German and the French. I don't really believe in the American grip, just because it's either French or it's German. Anything in between is just kind of like what you make up. So,
good point.
But one thing that I've tried to get away from in the beginning, my grip would mainly be with the index finger and the thumb. It was only until a couple years ago a friend of mine suggested to use your middle finger and your thumb.
Cool.
Because for some reason, without your index wrapped around, as that being your primary grip between your index finger and your thumb, it takes a lot of tension off of your forearm just by making that simple switch. So that's something that I've tried to incorporate, and always, trying to keep my pinkies on the stick. But mainly, one of the other bad habits I got from being in the drum line was when I went to the bass line.
I remember this
story,
yeah.
I went from match grip on snare to the bass line in which you're standing like this.
Striking completely different.
So that became a problem for me with my left hand, because it's my left dominant hand, it just kind of did what it wanted to do. So to this day, when I roll, it's still kind of funky, because I kind of hold my left hand like it's playing bass drum, and I also have a bad habit of still keeping my thumb like that.
Yeah.
Traditional, I didn't start playing traditional until I went to college. I mean, most of the guys, like I said, in high school just played match grip, so my traditional grip was just pretty much what I learned from them, and then I started watching videos, so I just place it to what's really comfortable for me. Just resting on the ring finger, with the middle and the index finger, just kind of as a guide. Mainly I'm holding the stick just
thumb up, right?
Right.
Okay. Yeah. I did a little messing with this grip and did the same exercise. It's interesting, yeah.
Yeah.
With the
I use a lot of thumb up. Nice. I saw Dave Weckl. Yes, Dave. I saw Dave Weckl talk about that on one of his videos that Freddie Gruber elaborated on too. So, I mean, two guys, I think they know kind of what they're talking about.
See,
so.
A lot of guys thumb down, man.
Yeah.
I do.
So I like the thumb up.
I do too.
That's just me. It's usually not wrapped around the stick. But typically, I only play traditional when I'm on the pad. I don't play it across the kit. I did when I first started, but after a while, I just realized, I think it looks cooler, but I just can't do it. I just got to go traditional. I mean, untraditional.
Very cool.
So,
well, thanks, man.
Yeah, no problem.
All right. We'll be back later.